while I was doing my tidy little bit of analysis to figure out whether the basic or the trial plan made sense, and we did this whole analysis of saying, well, at what number of sessions does the trial plan give me the same cost as the basic plan? And I did this whole calculation. I said, oh, it's at 5 sessions. I didn't realize it, but the guy at the front desk of the yoga studio was watching me the whole time. And then all of a sudden he said, well, you know, that's all cute what you did, Sal. I understand what you said. There's some number of sessions where 12S is equal to 20 plus 8S, where we get the same exact cost. And so you set 20 plus 8X is equal to 12 plus S. Or another way you could say it is, the C that 20 plus 8S gets is going to be the same as the C that 12S gets. So we just equate them, and then you solved for S, and then you solved for the cost. But the guy says, I have a different way of doing it, and I'm curious to see if I'm going to get the same answer. So his way of thinking about it, he says, look at this right here. We know from our basic plan that the total monthly cost is going to be equal to $20 per session, or it's actually going to be $20. It's going to be a $20 upfront fee plus $8 per session times the number of sessions. So we know that. And the whole thing we wanted to think about is, at what number of sessions do we get the same cost for both the basic and the trial plan? So he says, I have an idea of turning this into an equation of only one unknown. Right now it's an equation of two unknowns. I have a certain cost that's dependent on a certain number of sessions. But he has at least he thinks he's got a way of getting rid of the C. He says, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just subtract a C from the left-hand side. So he says, I'm just going to subtract a C from the left-hand side. And then I quickly point out to him, I was like, look, you can't just subtract one side from you can't just do one thing to one side of an equation, then the equality won't be true anymore. And he's like, oh, no, don't worry. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side of the equation. And so I tell you, well, what good would that be, subtracting C from both sides? Because then you're going to end up with a C on the right-hand side. You're going to end up with 20 plus 8S minus C. So you're not going to get rid of the C. You're still going to have two unknowns. He's like, no, Sal. You don't get it. I'm going to subtract C from the left-hand side. But I know that we're looking for an S where 12S is going to give us the same as whatever C is. This cost, whether I use the basic plan or whether I use the trial plan, I'm going to get the same cost. So I'll subtract the cost, whatever that cost is, that same cost that either the basic or the trial plan will give me, I'll subtract that from the left-hand side, because that'll cancel out with that. But from the right-hand side, I'll just subtract 12S. So he says, I'm just going to subtract C from the left-hand side, and I'm going to subtract 12S from the right-hand side. So I'm wondering, is this a valid thing to do? He's essentially subtracting this equation from that equation. He's subtracting the C from the left-hand side, and he's subtracting this 12S from the right-hand side. Does that make any sense? Well, let's just think about it. We know that if we have an equation, if we add or subtract one thing to one side, we have to do the same thing to the right-hand side. What he's doing, he's saying, look, we know for either plan we use, we know that there's some number of sessions where we're going to get the same cost. So let's subtract that same cost from the left-hand side. And that's going to be the same thing as 12S. We know that this has to be true. We know that both of these statements have to be true at this point of equality. So he says, look, if these two things are equal to each other, subtracting a 12S is completely equivalent to subtracting a C. So this actually is a valid operation. He is subtracting the same thing. He's subtracting a C over here, and he's subtracting a 12S over here. We know they're the same thing because we're putting that constraint on us. We know that both C has to be equal to 20 plus 8S, and C has to be equal to 12S. Because C has to be equal to 12S, we can subtract C from one side and 12S from the other. But let's see if this actually gets us anywhere. So if we subtract C from one side and 12S from the other, what do we actually get? Well, let's think it through. On the left-hand side, on the left-hand side, if I have c minus c, well, I just end up with 0. They just completely negate each other, and there's nothing left here on the left-hand side. So I just have 0 on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, I have the 20 still. I have the 20. And then I have 8 of something, and then I'm subtracting 12 of something. So 8s's minus 12s's is going to give me negative 4s's. So that's going to give me negative 4s's. So this is interesting now. I now have one equation and one unknown. That one unknown is s, and so I should be able to solve for that s. But how can I do it? Well, I always like to isolate my variable on one side of the equation. And so now I'll isolate it on the left-hand side. And as you know, there's many, many ways of doing this. And so what can I do if I want to get the s's on the left-hand side and get rid of them on the right-hand side? Well, if I want to get rid of them on the right-hand side, I'm subtracting 4s's here. I just have to add 4s's. But once again, I can't just do that to the right-hand side. Then the equality won't be true anymore. I have to also do that to the left-hand side. And so what will that give me? Well, we get 0 plus 4s on the left-hand side, which gives us just 4s. And that's going to be equal to, on the right-hand side, negative 4s and 4s, they negate each other. We're left with just 20. So we're left with 4s is equal to 20. To solve for s, we just divide by 4. We have 4 times something, the special number of sessions, is equal to 20. Well, 4 times something divided by 4 is just going to be that something. But we can't just divide the left side by 4. We also have to divide the right-hand side by 4. So we're left with s is equal to 20 divided by 4, or s is equal to 5 sessions, which is exactly the answer we got before. And then we can go back into either of the plans and see that the cost will still be $60. And so what was neat here is that both myself and the guy at the front desk of the yoga studio, we had very, very different approaches to solving this problem. But because what each of us did was logically correct, and this is what's really neat about algebra, we got to the same conclusion. As long as we do logically correct things, we will always get to the same answer.